It's another day in Minecraft, and as you can see, I have my work clothes on because we have a lot of work to do. So I think we better get started. Today we're going to be building a railway station to the little village nearby. If you can, let's see, look through there. It's kind of hard to see because it blends in with the cliffs. But right there where my marker is the lava waterfall, lava fall that I showed you before. And then right in here is the village. You can barely make it out. And we're going to be making a rail system to the village so that we can take all of our treasures that we found down in the abandoned mine and get there quickly and easily. Right in this area, we're going to be putting up a station for the railway cars to be parked, and the tracks will go right across through here where that wooden thing I did to show me where I needed to build, and then over to the houses over there. And then that way we can load up the train cars with all of our treasures, all of the ore we find, coal, even cobblestone, and the different types of rocks that we do mine out of the ravine. And then we can send them on over there, and that'll be so much easier than going back and forth with my small inventory. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and build this because it's pretty much just laying down rock and wood, and then I'll bring you back as I finish it up. I'll be making the railway station here also. Did I hear some? I don't have my armor on, but I haven't seen much danger around here at all. So hopefully I won't need my armor. Okay, well, I'll bring you back as soon as I get some of this done. Well, I have been working on the railroad all the livelong day, and I'm just about through placing down the railing, so I thought maybe you guys might want to help with that part. And we'll finish it up and try it out. I found that you put the railings down unless you're going uphill or around in curves. You don't need a lot of power rails. But we put one every once in a while. That's what is called a power rail, and you need these redstone torches in order to power them. Like I was saying in the other episode, redstone torches, I mean redstone gives some kind of electricity. Did you see how that lit up? That gave it power. Let's get that off. See, it got really dark. And now if I place it back down, that gives it the power it needs. I'm not sure what powers redstone. I haven't ever looked into the history of Minecraft or no, but anyway, that should do it. It goes all the way down here to the village. I'm not going to finish this yet because my plan is to fill all this in with dirt because it's just a little bit too low. And that'll help us give a better base for reaching the rest of the village. And I have a plans for building my house down here in this area. So, not finished right here yet. Let's go ahead and put a fence post to keep our cart from running away from us. And not quite finished. I did run out of railings. Not run out. Oh, I won't ever run out, I don't think, after all the railings that I got, but I have to go back to the mine to get them. See the fence railings? They ended up. Oh, that chicken, he got in somehow. I was hoping the fences would keep the chickens and the sheep and livestock off of the track. And there's an egg. Let's pick up that egg. We might want to probably, once we get our village started, we're going to give the village a complete makeover. In fact, I need to stop calling it the village. I've decided to name the village Briarwood. I think that's a really good name. If you played Free Realms, you know Briarwood was one of the little areas that we played in. It was kind of dark and spooky, but ours isn't going to be dark and spooky. We're going to try to make our little Briarwood village very happy. Hopefully, we need to get busy because we've got so much to do. All of this area needs to be filled in with dirt, and that lake, that's just terrible. Nobody wants to go fishing there. We need to make us a nice fishing dock and fishing area to fish. But anyway, I'm getting sidetracked. Here we go. We want to try out our tracks so far. I need to eat something. And of course, it's raining. Gosh. Why does it rain so much in this game? Why does it rain in any game? I feel like that it's constantly raining. So what you do to ride the train is you put your cart down. There are mine carts that you can put chests in, and that's what we will be doing too, in order to transport things back and forth. But you right-click on your mouse, that puts you in the cart. See, we're sitting in our cart. See, that works really good, huh? Are you ready to go? All right, so here we go. We're going to hope we don't run over this chicken. It sure acts like it wants to. You press your forward key, and then when you hit those power rails, it gives you a spurt of power. So here we go. We're going to go all the way up to the mine shaft where we built our station. It's really a short little trip, but it does get tiresome having to see. That's all there is to it. So, yay, we did it. See, that's going to be really fast, huh? We have to pull the fence up here because I don't want to. You can place the redstone torches out here, but this is our walking path, so I think it'll be fine if we place them there. That may be how that chicken got across, but we won't worry about it too much. One thing you do have to do if you don't want livestock to get in your cart and decide to ride the train back and forth. Well, you know what? This is such a short area. I don't think it'll matter. You can pick your cart up every time and put it in a storage box. And left my crafting table out here. I had to keep crafting things. Kept breaking my shovels. But anyway, that's how much I have so far. I need to finish off the fencing. The railing, and then I'm going to start filling dirt in because we definitely want to get started on our Briarwood village. So I will get to busy doing filling in the dirt, and then I will bring you back. Okay, I kind of wanted to give a little walking tour of the village of before and kind of share with you a little bit of what we're talking about doing to the village. So that way you can have a look at the before and then an after, so you'll know how much we've done. But all of this needs to be filled in with dirt. We'll move the lake. We'll put a lake somewhere else where it's a little bit better place. This is like a lake that had the dam burst and completely just went nuts. Okay, so we'll fill all this in, probably maybe up to the top of this garden. Maybe, I think so. And that'll get it up to the top of these doorways. We need to fix it so these villagers can get in their doors. So that will pull this up. We're going to kind of even all this ground out. I did lower the well a little bit, the sides. I don't know if you remember, but it had ugly sides, and the poor villagers were getting stuck in there. I put some stone down in the bottom so they don't have to bounce up and down, bounce up and down. They can easily get out of the well now. Some of the houses, I will lower them completely. They're up too high, and I would rather have everything at ground level so it looks nicer. So that means a lot of this ground, like right here, all of this will come off. We'll just flatten this down a little bit. Lower these houses down. I'm going to combine some of the houses. Like these two little houses can be combined. And maybe they'll be a storefront, and we'll have our villagers in there with their little counters, and they'll be It will be able to trade with them easily if they're inside their little storefronts. All of this needs to be smoothed out a little bit. This library, this is really good. We just need to fix it so that there's, I think, a little bit more room. And one thing while we're thinking about remodeling is we will be adding doors. And the way it scientifically works, a door by itself, I think it with attached to one block or something like that, will work as a door for a villager, but we don't want to do that. We want to actually have real doors for real houses. This little house is just adorable and it doesn't really need a lot of work, but we do teach. I think this is the butcher shop. In reality, I think this is what they call the butcher shop. This is his counter, and this is where people can eat their sandwiches or something. I don't know, but I believe that's what this is. So we might leave it the same. This little house is lit too small, so because there's a lot of room over here, we'll fill in all this water with dirt. Look, that garden is way over there. So what we'll do is we'll fill all this in with dirt and then make an addition to this house. And hopefully we will get our, we need 21 doors all total. This is a very tiny village. This is one of the smallest villages I've ever seen. It has huge gardens though, which is really, look at all this. I mean, this is just amazing. These gardens go forever. So that's really good. So what we'll do is add on to these houses that are existing and then also build on some more houses. And then what we'll do is eventually get 21 doors. We need 10 villagers. And then we'll have spawned in some iron golems and they march around and protect your house, your villages from danger, from mobs and stuff. There's our train track right there to get a point of reference to the railroad train to the desert. And we'll end up, we need to make us, I see two sheep wandering around, so that'll be a start. We'll get these sheep, make a pen, and start breeding sheep for wool, and then we can have different color sheep. We'll try to make the sheep all the different colors. There's 16 different dye colors. Then we need some pigs. We need to make a pig farm. Oop, it's getting dark. And a cow farm. We need hide and all that. And then eventually maybe go on a trip and get parrots. Wouldn't that be fun? And find some wolves. There's just so much to do. All right. I'll be back. I've got to do a lot of like landscaping with the dirt, and I won't make you sit through that. So I'll come back after a little bit and show you what I've done. Well, I've been working on the landscaping some. We're making progress, but it's taking a long time to get it all the way I want it. I'm pretty much down into this area now, but I've completely filled in most of all of this. Over here, you can see where I'm filling in a lot and evening the terrain out just a bit. I may even take it down one more. I'm thinking it just might be easier. This house I started working on a little bit, combining them. I was thinking about making that into a village shop. And so I brought it down one, I lowered it one, and now I'm thinking I need to lower it another one. So I may make it a two-story. But so all of this has been leveled out, and it's just so much better. My goodness, it's so much better already. The reason I want, what I wanted to show you though, see this has all been evened out here. That is just so much better. But this is where I'm working right now, and I saw this, so I thought maybe I could show this to you. Clay is one of my favorite materials to use in Minecraft because you can make clay pots. And when the clay pots, you put flowers, so they're like flower pots. So this is clay. You find it in the edge of water systems like lakes and rivers, and it looks just a little bit different. It's hard to tell, but once you figure out, you can go down and you collect it, and then it looks like this right here. See, it says clay. And then what you do is you put your clay in your furnace, and that will cook it into clay bricks. And with the clay bricks, you can with the clay bricks, you can make flower pots and make like real bricks that you can build out of. So that's a lot of fun. But anyway, it's kind of rare. So if you ever see it, collect as much of it as you can. All right, I'm gonna get back to digging. I'll be back with you in just a few minutes. Look here at this sheep. This is why you need to pick up your mine carts whenever you're not using them, because the sheep and the chickens will decide they want to go for a ride. Here, I'll give you a push. There you go. All right, see you in a little bit. I had to come back to the mine to get some materials and things for building with. So, just wanted to show you that sheep. I'll be back in a little bit. Yeah, we're making progress. I can show you a little bit, but right now I'm trying to figure out about how to the best way to do that building. But there's that poor sheep again. So much faster than walking. Gosh. All right, let's see if we can get this sheep out without. Did you see that? He was eating grass in the cart. There we go. Oh, and now he's stuck. Are you able to get out of there, sheep? Well, that's a predicament, isn't it? Oh my goodness. Can you get out now? Oh, my word. Let's see, we don't have anything to fix that with, and I'm full to the brim. Let's throw away this torch for a second. Where did my brick go? All right, for just a second, let's do away with this door. I brought these spider webs from the. There it is. I brought these spider webs from the mine that we'd found, that I found while I was. Oh, that's not right. I think you can make like trap lines or something. You have to be careful because sometimes if you go into temples, there's a. If you trip over that trip line, not trap line, if you trip over it, arrows shoot out like Indiana Jones. Okay, now then, get this other brick. My word. That's why you need to pick up your mine carts, because let's see. What can we draw? Okay, let's drop that torch again. There we go. Need to go put all this stuff away. Now everything's fixed. Okay, Mr. Cow, you don't get any ideas. Okay, so see, all of this is filled in. I need to get. I went to the mine to get my buckets because I need to put some more water in here to fill this up more. Because see, I did one more layer, and slowly the brown is turning to green. And once the brown all turns to green, you can make paths with the back side of your shovel. So, like, if I right-click my mouse, isn't that neat? It took me forever to learn about that. There. And we can just make paths. If we don't want to put like stone paths, we can make dirt paths. I won't finish all of them because you have to have so many green blocks to turn the brown blocks into grass. You have to have so much grass. So see how it's gradually turning all of that to grass. But if I turned it all to pathways right off the bat, there wouldn't be any green grass next to some of these. So I'm going to give it a little bit of time. It's turning green really quickly. It looks so much better, right? And here's my mess. So I'm trying to figure out. I don't think I want to go two stories. So that means I lowered it down again. So that means I need to chop off about half of this. So that's what I'm in the process of doing. I went back to the mine to get some more wood. Ooh. Anyway, a lot of this is going to be glass, so it won't be too bad. But I think it will look better once I get it done. All right, let's go sleep. Well, I'm just about finished with this little building. I'm going to try to make it into, like I said before, a shop maybe for some of the villagers. I need to figure out which villagers we can trade with. And we have plenty of string from cobwebs, that's for sure. But I can show you what I have so far of this building. But before I do, I made a little bit of a half of this building was may had a little observatory like that one over there up, so you can climb up the ladder and see, so you can climb up this ladder and then the villagers come up and look out over their land. But I wanted to show you how pretty and green our place is looking, and so much better, isn't it? Look how pretty. Still need to work on the well. Down there is where all that mess was before, so it's really coming together. Our beautiful farms, and I saw a black sheep a while ago, so the sheep are starting to come into our. I think they're enjoying our landscaping, but they're right through there is where the desert is, and that's where our. But you can see our bridge. This part of the desert over here is where our ravine is. It's just really close. I can't believe how close this village is to that desert ravine, but you can see that desert goes for a really long, far away area. And then over here, it's pretty much just normal trees, oak trees, and a few birch trees. And nothing really spectacular. This is pretty much a grassland plains biome. And then you turn around, and then here's our, we have a beautiful view of the lava flow over there, and that's where we came. That's the direction we came from, over those mountains, all the way up north. I'm facing north. This direction is north. We came a really long way to get here. Oh, I also built this bridge. I haven't finished it. I need the railings, but I found when I was I had to harvest a lot of dirt, dig up a lot of dirt in order to do my landscaping, and I found this cave over here when I was out and about, so I made a little bridge, and I think I'll make a little pathway over here so that when we need items in a pinch, we can go over there. We sure don't need to worry about looking for diamonds or anything, though. We have so much quality materials now that we spent a little bit of time in the mines. Okay, I'm going to show you this. Let's go down. Let's see. I'm not really good at these ladders. Let's see. You kind of turn. There we go. Not too bad. See, I need to do this window area. We changed this into nice picture window, and I need to put in the other door. And think he likes it. I wonder if he's waiting to see, for me to finish putting the door on. But there's what it looks like now compared to what it looked like before. Just so much better. And that's our first building. We have lots more to work on, but I think that's all that we'll worry about today. The sun is going down, so I think with this sunset, maybe we'll say goodbye and let's get to where we can see the sunset. And we'll see you next episode. I'll be working on the. Woo, it's getting dark. I'll work really fast and try to do some more buildings, and then next episode you can see what I've done. Bye for now.